Companies Act 2016 has actually amended a lot of things compared to 1965 Act. Now, under this 2016 Act, the company no longer is required to issue share certificate unless those shareholders requested. So this is provided under Section 97. Compared to the 1965, the companies are required to issue the certificate immediately after the company has been incorporated. Now, I believe every one of you in the class have actually seen a sample of the how does a share certificate look like. I've actually showed to everyone. Okay, now if a shareholder requests a certificate, the company shall within 60 days from the application send that particular certificate to that particular shareholder, stating the name, the class of shares, and the number of shares held. Now, if you don't do it, if your company do not do it, that particular shareholders are entitled to go to court to apply for an order. Now, that order, we direct the company and whoever officer to deliver the certificate within the period specified in the order. So, normally, standard request, normally they will ask you to actually deliver within 40 days. I don't know. It depends. It actually depends on the order. Now, you must ensure if there are requests by those particular shareholders, you must actually give a certificate. Now, why do you think that all these shareholders like to have a copy of their shares? They would like to have it a copy of those ownership. Now, most of the time, we know that shares are transferable, their goods those shareholders actually they are more secure, I believe so, because the company will actually list down the name of the shareholders as well as the name of the members in those registers. Okay, now these particular shareholders they don't cite those documents, so probably there's a fear that the company makes mistakes. So this is one of the reason why perhaps those shareholders requested for a copy of the certificate. Now, section 101 subsection 1 provides that entry of a person's name in that particular register of shareholders in that register of members as shareholders prima facie proof their prima facie evidence that particular shares are actually vested on the shareholders. Okay, so what does prima facie mean? So basically it means that it is something sufficiently sufficient to state that that particular shareholder is having interest in that particular company unless you prove it otherwise. Okay, so it raised some rebuttable presumption so this particular presumption you must actually you can actually disprove it in court. Now, whenever a person's name in that particular register it raised this particular prima facie some people pronounce it as prima facie a presumption that that particular person is a shareholder. Now, that's why some of the shareholders feels that they scared that those register of members can be amended at any time because it's not within their within their possession. So that's why they would actually like to have a copy of the certificate. Now, once you are registered shareholders, okay, you are entitled to exercise votes, okay. You're also entitled to receive notices as far as meetings are concerned or any other than that relating as a shareholders. And then you are able to receive distribution in respect of the shares such as dividend. And you can also entitled to exercise other rights and powers attached to that share. All these are given under Section 101, Subsection 2 of the Act. Okay, now what happened when you issue an incorrect share certificate? Okay, what happened? This is very interesting. We can look at this case, Birkinshaw and Nichols. Now, this case happened in 1878. The court says that when a certificate states that a shareholder has fully paid shares. Sorry, when a certificate states that a shareholder has fully paid shares, when in fact they are partly paid, there was mistake done by the company. So the company is stopped from denying that they are fully paid. Okay, there was a mistake by the company. Okay, when in fact it was partly paid. So company can no cannot deny that they cannot deny. Okay, so basically, it means that that particular shares are fully paid. You can no longer deny. Oh no, it's not correct. Okay, we made a mistake. Bear in mind, certificate actually is a prima facie evidence previously under previous act compared to 2016. Now, how do you know that the correct one is in the register of members? Okay. Now, in this case, in this Berkinshaw and Nichols case, okay, when the company is stopped from denying that they are fully paid, okay, stop is a legal term, so company is unable to make calls on the shares. Make calls here means if there are some unpaid shares. So because this particular shares partly unpaid, so because the company made mistakes, the court says that they are not able to call for or to call on the shares because they have actually made a mistake and they are stopped from denying that those shares are fully paid shares. Okay, careful, if the court relies on this case, if you made a mistake as a company secretary, you have to pay consequences. Okay. We have another interesting case. This case is regarding there are some forgery being made. Now, A, a person, he says that he is the owner of the shares. Okay. So he actually sell those shares to B. Now B rely on those certificates, not knowing actually those certificate belongs to C. Now it was A was not the true owner. Basically, A has forged the document. He has forged the shares. Okay. Basically, in this case, there was transfer being made from C's name to B's name based on that certificate. Okay, so what will happen if such matter happens again in under the Companies Act 2016? This case happened way back 1868, and cases that falls under 1965 Act still follow riba here. Now, what happened if it still happen now? For companies which issue share certificate, okay, and there was actually a transfer of shares when the share certificate has been forged, what will happen? So if it happened here, you still follow this riba here case. Now, in this particular riba here case, what did the court says? Okay, in this case, C, because he is a true owner, the court says that he is entitled to have his name restored to the register. Okay, so B, who acquire a defective title, he has no rights on that particular shares, but he can take actions against A on fraud. So probably B in this case can actually claim from A. So in this case, the court held that company was liable to B for damages because the company was stopped from denying that A was the true owner. Remember, denying liability, but okay, at the same time, okay, C company must also restore C's name, okay, as the true owner. Okay, it's very good that you can, if you can actually read this case. Now, just the court, the judge in this case stated, if you make a representation with the intention that it shall be acted upon by another, and he does so, meaning that particular person acted upon on that representation, you are stopped from denying the truth of what you represent to the fact. Okay, this is more on misrepresentation as well. Okay, so this is those two cases. I believe it's sufficient to show on the liability of incorrect certificate and some fraud. Okay.